Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Bakker, author of Candida Crusher. Thanks for checking out my video. We're going to talk a bit more about biofilms today, about the different, particularly about the different bacteria, Candida or yeast, and but associated with biofilms, but also the different diseases that are associated with biofilms. So biofilms are associated with many different types of chronic diseases particularly. So I'll just read out a list here of some of the diseases associated with biofilms: recurrent tonsillitis, recurrent ear infection, chronic sinusitis, bronchiectasis, so lung problems, osteomyelitis, like bone infections, chronic cystitis, urinary tract infections, kidney stones, chronic prostatitis, cystic fibrosis, recurrent vaginal yeast infections, pneumonia, endocarditis, so inflammation, of the heart. So there are many this is just a few. There's like hundreds and hundreds of different kinds of infections associated with biofilms. So it's a very important field now that a huge amount of research is being conducted in many different countries, in China, in Pakistan, in Japan, in America, in Germany. Many countries now are really studying biofilms, particularly the formation and the best eradication ways. But I think they're really barking up the wrong tree when it comes to pharmaceutical medicine, because they haven't really found much joy yet using these anti-kind of drugs for biofilms. So what are some of the examples of this, of bacteria associated with biofilms? Well, E. coli is a common one. E. coli can be good or bad. And certain types of E. coli, particularly large amounts of it, affect people very much and cause urinary tract infections. So it's very easy for you to get a colony of E. coli that just sit there and keep causing problems there, and recurring amounts of antibiotics are not really going to do much there when a biofilm is present. With that, extracellular mucopolysaccharide, enclosure we spoke about in a previous video, where it's almost like a tent in covering these bacteria, or antibiotics can't really get into anymore. Staphylococcus aureus, very common bacteria that we find there, with many different kinds of skin infections, for example, but endocarditis, like heart infections, infected medical devices like joint prostheses and heart valves. These are all areas where biofilms love to grow, right? Catheter infections, very common. Many patients I've seen in wheelchairs over the years have got biofilm, right? Pseudomonas, a very common bacteria that we find with ear, nose, or throat disease, lung disease, cystic fibrosis, pneumonia, very common in that. We also find a lot of Pseudomonas in patients with bad bowel problems. Another one I see is Citrobacter. It's another bacteria, particularly Citrobacter fundi, is a very common one. And I remember reading a paper only recently, the Journal of Microbiology Technology, December 2013. This is a medical journal. Effects of nutritional and environmental conditions on biofilm formation of Citrobacter. So basically the article stated that the best approach to eradicating biofilm was through diet and lifestyle. That's really what the article said, which is the kind of work that we do as naturopaths. So Streptococcus mutans, which is a typical bacteria that we see with plaque formation. So I hope you're brushing your teeth 2 or 3 times per day. It's important to get rid of bacteria out of the mouth that cause plaque, because these bacteria can cause a lot of problems further downstream in the gut. Healthy mouth, healthy gut is what I always tend to say to people. Klebsiella, another bug found often there with prostate infections, urinary tract infections, but also pneumonia. And the list goes on and on. There are many different types of bacteria. A list could be as long as your arm that are associated with biofilm formation. So it's important for you to understand how biofilms are formed. So check out my other video, The 5 Stages of Biofilm Development. And in subsequent videos, I'm going to talk about eradication of biofilm. So thanks for tuning in today.